of all contemplate our thoughts, only then can we have peace in our world. And last one. One chance to live, one chance, I was told. No chances to get young or only one chance to grow old. One chance to love, one chance to live. One chance to change, but it's one chance to live. And we have a number of chances. Probably about three. And over the years, it's had its ups and downs. And to tell you the truth, I don't think you can't be happy. But I've just been through. Always been through, got blessed, and I've been blessed. And I'm going to miss you so much, Wayne. I love you. We all do. So many memories.
As you got older, you got wiser as well, and you have all these reasons, we have these conversations. I recently moved back to the area, reconnected, I never lost the connection, no, 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 and then just got tired. And then, we used to come over, but I had friends over, and then, you know, everyone's there, and I was having a reason. When my waist let the top, yeah, I started to really have a pro, that it boy.
Come find me, waiting at the edge of the earth. From here, I see all life's beauty and everything's worth. Every wing flutter of birdsong, every laugh, every tear. Everything you love about me is a reminder that I'm near. The view from the edge of the earth is beautiful, but bittersweet, as I watch those I care for journey to the place where we meet. But always know, whoever guides me, I will be watching over you. So celebrate me in my life today, and smile when the roses bloom. And keep walking down your path, much as it hurts to do. Keep walking and come find me waiting at the edge of the earth for you.
More music. not the family could control me, no one could, he couldn't control me. I waited, come on, Jack, I need showering, go to bed. And I went to bed, and I slept for 2 days, and he was stroking my hair. He was there for me. That's 24 years ago. And he's always, always had that respect for me. Always been there and always loved me. And today brings back all that. It brings back the strength that he had, the maturity that he had. When Kaz had me, Elite had me, and we might not see each other every day, Delete, but you know why we don't see each other? Because it's a big, big part of our lives. It's a big chapter. It's a big chapter with Wayne, and Wayne always, always loved me and cared for me throughout everything. If I had a bad day, he knew I had a bad day, he texted me. Kaz always been there. Things would go good, we get older, things go wrong. But the thing is, I've always got that Wayne and Kaz's back. Always, I knew me, I love you to the fans. I just don't always call the difference back memories. But Wayne had me, and I cannot believe today I am burying Wayne. That was there, and it held me together as a child, but now I couldn't do the death for myself. But you know what, Wayne? Tell you now, you would cry, and God, you're in the best place, you're better than us. And you know what? I love you so much. Sorry, I've not been there for the last couple of days, really. I couldn't. But I'm there. I love you, Wayne. I love you, Kaz. I love you.
Wayne is also related to my wife. I think they're cousins. And many times Wayne would come to the house, he'd knock on the door, and he would say, "Excuse me, sir, can I get a tent? I want to go and buy one or two things." Wayne came to the house and he said, "Oh," he said, excuse me, sir, I'm not lying. I've got a friend at the house. We're cooking some food, but I'm sure some chicken. Do you have chicken? I said, "Wayne, come on. You know we're always here for you, right? You don't even tell me you have a friend at the house. If you're hungry, just say you're hungry. I'm going to give you food. There's always food here." And so Wayne was always there. He would come to the house, knock on the door. He would ask anytime. We were always there for Wayne. But one memory I have of Wayne is actually Wayne and Kaz, because Auntie Betty, who was his nanny. Kaz, at one point in time, Kaz, this young man here, just started reproducing children after children. This man is so fertile, you see. And Auntie Betty said to Wayne, "So Wayne, have you got anything in your trousers? Your younger brother is just reproducing. What's wrong with you?" And so I think Wayne was inspired. Wayne said, "Okay, just wait for me. I'm going to come." And so Wayne started too. And now we have beautiful children here. But Wayne, we love you all. And God bless you. I just want to leave with this this verse here from the book of John, chapter 5. As a minister, if you give me the pulpit, I'm always going to say something from the word of God. So John, chapter 5, verses 28 and 29, Jesus speaks and says, he says, "Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming in which all that are in the graves shall hear his voice and shall come forth. They that have done good unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation." So Jesus says there will be two resurrections. The resurrection of those who rise to receive eternal life, in the resurrection of those who rise to receive damnation. But Jesus says that he's giving us the opportunity. He says, "For God so loved the world promised that whosoever believes shall not perish, but have eternal life. I don't know why we deny that, because God has given us a free gift of life. All we need to do is to believe it in our hearts and to confess it with our mouth and give our life to Christ, so that when he comes again, we can rise to eternal life. Wayne, good night, and God bless. Thank you.
So tonight, for Wade, I'm going to be flicking dust. I'm going to be stamping. I've got my knees and hips, but I'm telling you now, I'm still going to walk up for him. I'm still going to get down.
I used to take the kids.
in the middle of winter, we used to go to Wales and just let the wind blow out the cobwebs. And this particular day, I could not find Wayne, and I'm looking. I'm scared. It's not even in the country, so I'm scared. It was about seven. I'm scared. I'm starting to cry now, starting to get upset. I look up to the heavens and say, shit. Like, where is this boy? What's the meat going to do to me? And in the distance, see Wayne up a tree. And that was the day I knew Wayne was destined to fly. And since then, I have seen him climb trees, buildings, jump from buildings, climb. When Delete is locked out of the house, he calls Wayne. And Wayne will scale up the bricks. So Wayne, fly high.
Yes.
See that building over there? This was whilst we were in college. He's like, see that building over there? And the backflip off it. Everyone's like, Wayne, shut up, you mop your head. None of that. The next week, he did exactly that. He brought our whole big giant crew, turned around and said, watch this. Backflip completely landed, completely fine. Everyone was just like, this is crazy, he's off his head. Just want to say, he's a top dude. He's a soldier. Even though you've fallen, I salute you now. You will never be missed. Everyone knows that.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry about that, please, because this person is not supposed to be inside this premises. Okay? My apology.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Okay. Once again.
Okay, all right. So what I want to remember is what we heard before, which was fly high. You know? Fly high. I don't know if you know what. Now, I'm an older guy, I don't know who the local artists are at the moment. But you know, I used to like, I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it every night and day. I'm here. Spread your wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. Yes, ma'am. Hear me running through that open door. Spread my wings and fly away.
can fly. I believe I can fly.
And it's going to be Auntie Debbie is going to come and sit somewhere around the throne of God. So let's give a big round of applause to Auntie Debbie and she comes.
I can do off things. The Wayne was the guy doing off things. I do it on the ground. I can do it. Try a little bit of foam up and left and with one that's left and
that place where Wade
a reading of Psalm 23 by Diane Bowe.
For others.
God is a friend who holds our hand in the dark periods of life when we feel lost and afraid. Even if we're good at hiding it, his hand is always outstretched, ready to take us and guide us until the dawn breaks again. He speaks about having a meal in the presence of our enemies. The background to that is, if someone was on the run, if someone was going through trouble, there would be these different tribal leaders, places that you could go, like the Seventh-day Adventist, the minister who shared earlier, Wayne would go to his home. He needed something. These tribal leaders would provide safe passage for people. So what would happen if you were on the run, if someone was trying to out to get you, if you could get to one of these people's homes, they would protect you. No one could come in, the enemies could come in. They could look in the window, see you happy in your Kentucky, yeah? See you happy in there, but it couldn't touch you. They provide shelter and protection for you. Delete family are going to need all of us to provide that shelter and protection over this next period of time. Because after today, people will go back their various ways, get back into their lives. But for those who love Wayne the most, life will never be the same again. It will never be the same again. And so they're going to need your ongoing love, support, and protection. God is a host who, at the end of our lives, welcomes us home to be reunited with those who have gone before us. That takes us back to that first image of Jesus, the one who loves, meeting Wayne, the one who is loved, to take him to another home with him. If you look at the altar, you'll see there's some candles, and there's one candle in the middle which isn't lit. There's a flame that isn't here. That light is shining in all of our own hearts. I bet when Jesus met Wayne, Jesus was on his hands. I'm sure they walked in the hands to begin with, then they stood, and then they flew together. The lead chose the beautiful next hymn that we're going to sing in a moment, How Great Thou Art. He speaks of God's creation, how wonderful it is. The last verse speaks of Christ taking us home. Wayne is with love in another dimension of life. Wayne lives on for some of us in our own DNA, in our memories, our hearts, and our minds. Later at the cemetery, we'll continue the process of letting him go, allowing him to fly, continuing the good work he showed us how to do by showing us how to be. He will return to the earth he fought so very hard to protect. During this next hymn, some of you who have been away for a few years or decades, now I know that some of you, if you've been back, you haven't been here for days or decades, you're saving up your little pennies, saying, when I go back to church, I'm going to save up, and I'm going to give something to the church. So it's going to be unkind for me to not allow you to bring all of that you've been saving up over the years, the weeks, the months, and the decades. Your suitcase full of $5. So there's going to be some buckets and some plates going around during this hymn, and we'd love to invite you to think about bringing a contribution to Ascension Church U. It's not a tax, it's not a ticket, it's a thank you. It's a thank you to God for giving us life and strength and for giving us community. Your giving will help us connect with faith and life in innovative ways. In May, we're going to hold a festival of Windrush, of the world celebrating wonder. Your giving goes towards us having a vision of a church which can be a key partner with Hume again. So thank you in advance for your gift. Saying that, you must feel free to let the plate pass you by. Just remember, it's not an ATM, it's one-way traffic, all right? Let's stand, and we're going to sing the hymn, How Great Thou Art. So let's stand and sing the hymn, How Great Thou Art, and play for working. Thank you.
Ben? Yeah. I was literally saying before Ben, what happened to you?
Could keep the respectful silence, please.
Yeah, it's Right, I'm
gonna go and find my mum.
Booted, eh?